Hey, Andy here, and welcome to another Microsoft Word tutorial. This time I'm going to explain to you how you can format images within your document. So we'll look at how you can resize them, how you can change their positioning, and how you can align them next to text within the document. So you can have the image on one side and text sitting parallel to the image, rather than, in this case, above and below. So let me take you through some of the basic options that are available to you. I've got a standard document here and I've inserted a number of pictures. All I need to do to be able to resize one of the images within the document is to simply click on it, and then I can grab from the corner and you'll see I'm changing the size there. The other thing you can do is once you've clicked on your image, you'll notice that in the ribbon here, a new option appears, a new tab at the top called Picture Format. And in here, what you can do is you can use the height and width adjustment here. Now, this little tick here means that the ratio is going to be kept even. So for example, if I adjust the width, it will adjust the height accordingly to keep the proportions correct on this image. So if I make the width 20 centimeters, you'll see that the height has increased to 13, but I can just drop this down. Personally, I would always recommend keeping this option ticked within your document. So you'll see the margin here is about 16, so I'm just going to drag this a little bit smaller. So changing the size of the image is a case of basically just grabbing the corner points, or as I said, using the picture format option up here. Another thing you can do though, let me just bring the size of this image down. If you wanted to change where the image lives on the page, you can put the cursor before the image and you can press the spacebar loads of times and try and bring it across. But that presents lots of issues, certainly when you want to try and align multiple pictures up in your document. Another thing you can do is you can press the tab key a couple of times. So I can tab across twice and it's pretty much in the center. But what I prefer, and which I think is the easiest method, is to click on your image and just use the standard formatting options you would use for text to move the image around. So you'll see, although it says when I hover on it, center text, it's actually going to allow me to center whatever I've selected. So in this case, it's centering the image. Now I can take this image here and I can do exactly the same. If I center it, I know that they are both right in the center of the page. So certainly using the formatting options when you've clicked on an image is a really, really quick and easy way and an accurate way of changing the position of the image within your document. Of course, if you need to left align, you can just use the left align formatting option and it will put it back to where it should be. So now that we have looked at some very, very basic formatting for our picture, let me tell you a little bit more about moving its position around the page and using the wrap text option. I'm going to pop this one back to left align, and let's say we wanted this piece of text that I've just selected on screen to sit to the right of the picture. What often people do is they'll maybe grab the text and try and move it up, but as you'll see, it just sticks it on the bottom corner of the image and we've still got all this space. Another thing that users do quite often is select the text and maybe cut it. So I've used Command X there, and then they'll use Control or Command V to paste it back in, and it does the same thing. And that's because essentially in Microsoft Word, you can only have one thing when we're using inline here. So we've got the image, the text has to sit above or below it. In this case, what you want to do is you want to click on the image and then right click and go down to wrap text. Now you'll see it tells you it's in line with text, which means text is below, above or below, but we can use one of these options such as square, tight, through, top and bottom to change how the text sits around this particular image. And you'll see there's two below, you can do behind or in front of the text. I'm going to go for square and then you'll see what happens, it moves the text up around the image. Now what you can do is you can drag the image down a little bit and have it positioned next to the text like this, or of course you can put in a little delete there and have the text sitting here nicely. Final thing I might want to do is just resize the image just to get it sitting perfectly and bring the next paragraph up a little bit. Now the important thing to note when you're using the wrap text option is when you click on an image, there's this little icon. This icon here, the anchor, means that wherever the text goes, the anchor image will go to. So because this anchor sits next to this text, you'll see when I put in a return, the image follows. By default, the anchor will go next to any text next to the image or where you've moved it, but you can actually click and drag the anchor and reposition it, and now it's sitting next to here. So when I move this piece of text, you'll see the image moves, but also when I move this piece, the image goes as well, okay? Personally, I would always leave the anchor just sitting next to the text that you want to sit next to the image, okay? So essentially, don't go moving that anchor unless you need to. Other things you can do if you right-click on the image, you'll see it in wrap text. You have this option for fixing its position on the page. What that does is essentially glues the picture or the image to the page and does away with this anchor, or you could think of it as dropping the anchor on the page in this position. And what that means is no matter where you move the text around, the image is stuck on the page in that position, okay? That's one of the options I would definitely never put on unless you need the image to always stick in that one place on the page. Moving it with text is a preferable menu option here. The final thing I want to highlight here is you can also go to Edit Wrap Boundary, and what you can do with that is you can grab some of these points just to expand the distance between the text and the image to give you a little bit more space if you need to. So I could put it roughly like that. That looks pretty much straight. And now I've got a little bit more of a gap between the image and the text. Okay, so now that we've got our image wrap options in place, if I go into the wrap menu, you'll see there's other things you can do as well. So for example, you could have text sitting in front or behind the image. So if I use in front, then you'll see what happens here is we can actually have the image sitting on top of the text. Or if I right click and use behind, then the image sits behind the text in here like that. So personally, I don't ever tend to really use these ones. I would always go for either the square or one of the other options and position the image like that. If you need to return it back to how it was before, then all I would usually do is put a return in front of this paragraph. So I'm going to use the return key and nudge it down. But before doing that, what I need to do is right click and go in line with text. So I'm going to move the image back in line with text. That will free up the text, and then I'll just put in my return down in here, and it will move the text underneath the image. So that's just some of the general picture formatting options you can use to move an image around, to resize it, and to align an image next to a piece of text. Do play about with these though. Have a practice using the wrap text options. There's lots of different ones in here, and you'll see within more layout options, you can also customize, for example, the distance from the text, and if you want to wrap the text on both sides or just one side only. And these options will change depending on which of these wrapping styles you have selected. Now, I really hope you found this video to be useful. If you did, please do give it a like and make sure you comment below to let me know how you're getting on using wrapping styles within your Microsoft Word document. If you've not already noticed, I have loads of different Microsoft Word, Instagram, and various other software application, mobile application, and web application videos on my YouTube channel. So do go and have a look at those. And if you haven't already subscribed, please do subscribe and make sure you tick the notification option just so you're notified about any of my future Microsoft Word or other tutorials that I release.